Keith Rucker here at VintageMachinery.org. So a little while back, we made these little feet to use on my LeBlanc lathe. Do a couple things. Mainly, I wanted to raise the lathe up a little bit off the ground because it was just sitting a little bit low for me. Really, that's the main reason. And then we'll have the little elevation screws that you can adjust will fit down a little dimple in the top, and these were gonna sit up under the lathe and just kind of jack it up off the ground. Now, I had a lot of comments from you guys when I did this video saying, hey, those are too small, they're not big enough around, the lathe's gonna fall over. Well, you know, respectfully, I kind of disagreed with a lot of you guys that I just really didn't think that was gonna be a problem. You know, this is about inch and a half, we're probably close to 2 inches in diameter. I felt like it would be fine, but one of the suggestions that came out was, hey, just take a round plate, weld on the bottom, you'll have plenty of a footprint, won't be a problem. Quite honestly, at the time, I'm like, well, that's not a bad idea, but I just don't know if I want to go to the trouble. But then, about a week or two ago, I was in a shop. I was visiting a friend of mine that runs a shop, and he's got a plasma cam in there where they do a lot of cutting out, torching out steel. And they had just run a job where they cut a bunch of big disc out. They were cutting holes in plate, and they had a bunch of these little plates just sitting around on the ground. I said, hey, can I have a few of those? He said, that by all means, take as many as you want. So I picked up about 10 of them, I only needed 8. Plan here, we're gonna take and weld these onto these plates. And yeah, I think it'll give me a little peace of mind. I know it'll make a lot of you guys happier that we'll have a little bit more of a foundation on there. So that's the project of the day. Let's zoom you in here. I'll kind of talk about what we're gonna do, and we're gonna go do it. So in case you haven't seen the previous video, this is the parts that we made. So these are what, about an inch and, almost 2 inches, 1 7/8 in diameter. We were shooting for about 3 inches tall on them. There's a little bit of variation in the height, which it really doesn't matter. Came in, just kind of beveled off the top, and then I put a dimple in the top, and this is where that set screw, that 3/4 inch set screw, will kind of go down into and sit. And this was to do two things. Number one, it was to jack the machine up off the ground, but also to, instead of having all the weight on that point in the middle here on my concrete floor, spreading that weight out a little bit over a little bit larger surface area. The machine's not that heavy. It's not too heavy for my floor, but still, it will be better than those little dimples sitting on the concrete. So a lot of people just concerned that, hey, you get that weight on there, you get all these things jacked up, something hits the lathe, they plop over. Well, maybe, maybe not. I'm sure that if you hit the lathe hard enough, yes, it would probably do that. But with 8 of these feet up under the machine and all the weight of the machine going down, it's a pretty heavy machine. I really didn't think it'd be a problem, but again, not a bad idea. Put it on there. You know, these discs here that we got are 4 inches in diameter, 1/4 inch thick. Weld that on there, and you got a much bigger area on the bottom. This is not gonna flip over. And two, it's spreading the weight out over a little bit larger area, which I think is not a bad idea at all. So game plan, you know, with the 1/4 inch up underneath these are gonna be just a little bit too high. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna take these back over to the lathe, we're gonna chuck them up in the lathe, and I'm just gonna face off about 1/4 inch on the bottom of all these. In fact, I'll probably go ahead and just measure them all, get them exactly the same length. There's a little bit of variability in the length of these. Really won't matter because we got adjustments really going up and down above it with the screws. But you know, while we got it, it'll be easy to go ahead and get them all the right length. Gonna go ahead, while I got in the lathe, we'll put a chamfer on the bottom of this, and that will just give me a place to weld. And then we'll come back over here to the welding table and get these centered up and run a bead around them. And I think we'll be done. Then give them a new coat of paint, and these will be ready to go on the LeBlanc lathe restoration. So let's get over to the lathe and get to work. So before we get going, just a little bit about my setup here. So we've got this chucked into 3-jaw chuck. I'm not worried about this. I know this chuck's got a little bit of run out, but we're facing. It's not anything that's super critical. as far as being perfectly concentric. You know, we could take the time and put it in the forge jaw or something, but it just really doesn't matter. We're just shortening the length here. Yeah, we'll put a chamfer on there, but even that's not that important. What is important is I want to get my length right, so I've got this set where I can get my calipers in here, so I can get the front back here past this point, the front, they fit in there. And right now, this one here, for example, this is about 10 thousandths over 3 inches. We're going to take that down to 2 3/4. I've already touched this off. I've got a dial indicator set down here that I can kind of see how far I'm coming in, and I can take measurements from time to time to verify where I'm at, and we're going to shoot for those links. Again, it's not super critical. I want to get them close, but I'm not going to sit here and spend a lot of time trying to hit it dead on nuts on. If I'm plus or minus 25 thousandths, we're good enough. Really, if I'm plus or minus 100 thousandths, I'm probably good enough, but we're going to shoot for better than that. So let's go ahead. We're going to get in here. We'll start facing these off, get these 8 to length, put the chamfer in them, and get them ready for welding. All right, we're going to probably make 50 thousandths passes on this, I think. So I'll go ahead and pull that in. I'm going to lock my carriage down, put a little oil on there, and let her feed off. Another 50. Looks like we got about 25 thousandths to go. I just dial that in. Should be the last pass. Let's verify the length. All right, we're about 2 thousandths under. Like I said, I'm not worried about hitting it just dead on. All right, now for the chamfer, I'm going to change tools out here. And we'll come in with this tool. And just put a little chamfer in there. That should be plenty, that's just for the weld. And I'll go over on the wire wheel and clean that paint off before we actually weld it, and we'll repaint them after we're done. All right, this one should be ready to come out, and I probably won't bore you with the rest of them. We'll just knock them out now. I said I wasn't gonna bore you with the rest of them, but I am gonna retry that 100 thousandths cut now that I got it in there, hopefully good and tight. Let's see how this goes. That's good. We're going to go ahead and do another one. More to go to get where we want. Right there. All right, that'll go a lot faster. I like that. While we're here, we'll go ahead and chamfer it. Let you guys just see another one. This one's got a little more run out on it, but it's fine. All right, I think we're ready to go ahead and start welding these up. I've got on my Lincoln Electric welding gear again that Jim Bollinger over at Do Right Fab was kind enough to send to me. He sent me a care package a while back. I got a chance to use some of this the other day, but I'm really excited about this. So I got me a nice Viking Series Lincoln Electric welding hood, self-darkening. Huge improvement over the one we've been using. We've got one out at the museum. I mean, it's probably, I don't know, 10 years old. But, and it works, there's nothing wrong with it, but this one is just so much nicer. We got a larger viewfinder in it. I can see through it when it's not darkened a lot better than I can the other one. But I really like this is the headgear. It's got this really nice strap that goes on here. It's just a lot more comfortable and easier to adjust. Jim also sent me the gloves, and I'm trying out this, he sent me a long sleeve welding shirt. It's not too terribly hot this morning, so still cool enough. I put this on, and this should give me some protection on my arms. Some of you guys are always giving me a hard time about that. So anyway, we're going to put this on as well. So I will say that I'm not a welding expert, guys. I'm passable at welding. I can do an all right job, but I'm not an expert by any means. If you're wanting some good welding tips, and learning how to weld, I would highly encourage you to go over and check out Jim Bollinger's channel at Do Right Fab. He's got some really good tutorials up there for MIG welding, TIG welding, etc. Last time I welded, I had a lot of questions about what kind of welding. They asked me, are you TIG welding? No, this is not TIG welding. This is MIG welding. It's a wire feed system. You basically got a wire in here that where the electrode is, and that's where the arc is, and it's constantly feeding a wire in. Instead of having to hand feed it in like you do a TIG. And through this nozzle down here, you've got argon gas coming out, which is an inert gas, and basically that keeps any kind of scale or whatever from forming while you're welding. Keeps it nice clean. It won't react with the air like if you just welding into the open air. So it's just putting an inert gas around there. But we're gonna go ahead and get in here and get these things welded up. So here's the process I'm using. I lay it up on here, and I'm just coming in here with a scale, going around, and centering this thing up like I want. And then we'll come over, tack it in place. And weld around. Voila. Well, there we go. We got our 8 feet here all put together. I don't think there's any chance of those tipping over. And it'll spread that weight of the machine out over even a little bit wider area on the floor, which will also be a plus. So success. We'll go ahead and get these cleaned up, shoot them with another coat of paint, and they will be ready to go under the LeBlanc lathe as soon as we're able to get back into the shop and get her set where I want. And that's probably gonna be one of the next steps on the LeBlanc restoration is getting these feet under the machine and getting the machine leveled. Well, that'll be a wrap for this episode, guys. Just a quick note, I'm filming this today on Labor Day 2016. Came out of the shop, got out here probably about 8 o'clock, and it's about 9:30, and we've got this project knocked out. So nice, quick, easy project on Labor Day. This is really all I had planned today. Gonna spend the rest of the day with the family. Gonna probably barbecue a little bit tonight. Cook something nice out on the grill. Hadn't decided what yet. My wife was going to go to the store and pick out something, but we're going to enjoy the rest of the day, and we'll get this video posted up for you guys as quick as we can. But I thought you would enjoy seeing this. And again, I know a lot of people were really worried about not having the extra support under here, so I'm sure some folks are going to be happy to see this improvement, and I do think it's an improvement. So thanks a lot, guys. As always, give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Leave me some comments, subscribe if you hadn't already, and share it on social media. All right, talk to you later.